Hi friends, welcome to Tutor's Funny channel. Today I'm going to teach the Java most popular framework, which name is Spring Boot. I'm going to start the Spring Boot framework step by step. Today is the first day. So I'm going to, without wasting time to explain the theory stuff, I go to the practical stuff. So I just go to the Google. First you have to type the Spring Initializer. This is the Spring Initializer, so click on this one. Okay, this Spring Initializer which help you to set up our Spring Boot application. So here, this is the respective website. So if you go for that website, you have selected the Maven project, language Java. Here Spring Boot, you don't select as a snapshot, right? This is the beta version, so you don't need to select this one. You have to select this one. This is the default one. They recommend that you select this one. Here group. This is a project group. Here artifact. Artifact and name both are same. Now I'm going to. This is my first application. So I'm going to write artifact first application. Distribution you can give anything else, right? The package name you can give here. This package name I'm going to give the same name, right? Com application first application. This is the name it will be getting here, right? Or you can, if you want, you can change the name. I will give the same name, right? Now here, you have to package. You have to select as jar, okay? So the Java, okay? You have to here. You have to identify the relevant which version you have installed in your machine. This is very important stuff, right? So first, go to the command prompt. Here there will be the command called java -version. Press enter key. I have installed the Java which version is 1.8, right? Okay, this is very important stuff. Okay, before you are learning Spring Boot, you must learn before Java core application. It will be must, okay? Otherwise you can't able to understand anything else, okay? So here you have to check on Java int, okay? You have installed in your machine Java int, okay? You have to identify the version. 1.8 means this is the 8 Java int. If it is 11, you can give as 11. If it is 15, you will give as 15, right? Okay, after that, this is the dependencies, okay? Here when you are working on the servlet and JSP, when you are connect the database, you have to download the appropriate jar file in order to connect with the database. Okay, if you want to upload the file, you have to upload the jar file. If you want to send the mail, you have to upload the you must download the appropriate jar file. So in Spring Boot, it's called as dependencies. We have to select as Maven. So here we have to add the dependencies, right? This is the first one. So I am going to add as a web, only web. Okay, I am going to connect with the RESTful and web application. So we have to select this one. Okay, Spring Web. Okay, this is the only starter dependency I have added. So now you have to select generate. Right. Now your project has been display as a zip file over here. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to go to the Eclipse, right? If you are not installed Eclipse in your machine, you just go to the Google and you have to install the Eclipse, right? When you install the Eclipse, when you go to the Eclipse, there will be the two stuffs are there. This is Eclipse ID for Java developers. This is the core Java part. You must download the Java Eclipse for J2EE. This is which is manage all the web application development. You just click on this one. You will be able to download and work it. Okay. Okay. This is the thing. Right. This is must. Okay. J2EE. Okay. Now I already installed and open it. Now first what I am going to do. The first step. I am going to go to the folder structure. This is when you open it, it is coming like this, a folder structure. I have made many projects over here. Now I'm going to open the my zip file. Okay, so file, import, go to the Eclipse general, there is the folder called general, project from folder, right, this one. Next, you have to this one, click on this one. Here today date I have selected this one, first application, select this one, open it, it will coming like this. Here you have to, this one you have to uncheck it, I have to make sure the Maven, this one, project expand application Maven, select this one and click finish. Right, now here, now first my project is loaded successfully here. Okay, so here this one, first application, this is the application which I am created, the Spring Boot app, this is the first application I am going to create in Spring Boot. Okay, first application I have selected in the Spring Boot, right? So what I am going to do here is, first here this port I needed, I just copy and paste it over here, right? Okay, now what I am going to do is, see, this is my Spring Boot files, okay? Here if you are expand it, this is the my package, okay? This package is coming from here. Here you can give com example first name, right? This is the our project name, this is our package, okay? What's the package, your name you are given here, this all the things are there. Here this one should be your package, okay? Com example first name, here this one, what is the name you are display here, the same name, right? The package will be displayed. If you double click, this is the main file, okay? This is the main method of Java, right? If you go for the core Java, you will be able to find the main method, the same main method here in your Spring Boot application, right? Okay, this is the Spring Boot application, this is the main method, the program which run, okay? So now what I'm going to do here is, this is called as annotation, right? So first, now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create the controller part. So first go to the our src main, this is the file, this is the our folder, right? Right click, new package, you have to give the package name over here, right? So you have to write com dot example dot, this is the name, first application, the same name, paste it here, dot controller. I am going to write first controller, this is the first, anything else you have to write first controller, right? Okay, this is first controller, click finish. Right, now your controller has been created successfully, this is your controller, okay? Right, controller, what I am going to do is, I am going to write the hello world program, simple hello world application I am going to run, I am going to create. So how to write here is, select the select the package, right click, new class, here you have to write the class which is here is, I'm going to write hello, hello, right, click finish. This is a simple program, okay, here hello class, okay, double click and open, this is simple, okay. Now here first what I'm going to do is here first I'm going to make the annotation, controller annotation, you have to write a controller annotation, controller, click here, import the control annotation, right? After that what I am going to do here is, you have to write this one, right? You have to write the annotation get mapping, get, okay. Instead of, first we have to create the method public string, we have to write the display, I am going to write the method which is name is display. Simply you have to write the display method, okay? Here I am going to write return, you have to write hello, what is the thing you are going to return, this method return hello world, hello world, right? Simple stuff, right? So now I am going to write here, first I am going to write git mapping, you have to write here get mapping, the same name I am going to get display, Okay, this is the get mapping, right? Display mean it will display what is the what you are written on this method. It will be display here. This is not error. It ask import the get mapping namespace, right? If you are imported, it is coming here. Sorry, this is things is here. Right. After that, what I'm going to say, I'm going to write another annotation we have to write here. This one should be get response body. Response body. Right. What this annotation does is, it this annotation which will tell you to the controller to display the your hello world message, right? This is the response body. What is you are written on this function, it will be telling to your controller to display the message, what is the message you are written here, right? This is the get mapping. It will be getting the values, right? What is the port you are given, and you have to write slash display, it will be display the output, right? Okay, don't worry about that, we'll see. Okay, now I'm going to save all things I have saved. Now here another important stuff is, we have to given the port. It is very important stuff, given the port. Go to the src main resources, application property, double click and open it. Here if you are run the Spring Boot application for the first time, the port will be 8080, right? If the port some machines already there, you can't run the Spring Boot application. So you have to custom, you have to port, you have to write it. Okay, so you have to write server.port. I just write the custom port like this. Okay, you can change any port. I'm going to write 8088, any port you can write. Okay, so you have to save all. After that, you can run the application. Your save all. After that, you can run the application. This is the console. So what I'm going to, how to run the application is, go to the, first you have to save all. Go to the your main method. This is the main method. First application Java. Right click, run file. This is the Java application. Right. It will be here. If you screen the screen, if you see the screen, Spring Boot is installed successfully. Now you are not getting any error here. You are get any error. Now how to run the program? Go to the local ast. What is the port you are given? 8888. Right. Press enter key. Nothing will be displayed. Okay. What is the message you have to display here? Hello world. What is the how to write here? Display. This is the get mapping we are given here. So you have to write display slash display display. This is the mapping. Now the hello world is displayed successfully. Okay, this is the simple stuff. Okay, now I just for the note you have to give here is you have to this is the directive you have to this out the path will be work. Display means slash display. What you are written in this function, it will be displayed. Okay, very simple. This out you have to write the hello world programming in Spring Boot application. If you have given the H tag, you can give what happened. Closed. Sorry, not here. We have to go to the first time you have to run the programming. Don't again you have to go and run it. Okay, so you have to change the port. Okay, if you are run again, simply you have to go to the debug. This is your running programming first. Application, okay. Again, you have to terminate and relaunch. It will be what you are done here. Save what you are change it here. It will be changes will be apply. Now you can refresh it here. Hello world will be become as a bold H1 tag. I will change it as a H1 tag. Okay, you can see here this is H1 tag. Okay. Now if you are given the tag H6 tag, you can see here what is the output. Save all. Debug, select this one again, terminate and relaunch. Now you can go here, see the output. Okay, this is the difference. Okay, so all the things you have to do like this, very simple. This how we will write the hello world programming in Spring Boot, very simple stuff. Okay, right. I will be continuing my next lecturing for the Spring Boot application. I hope you understood the things well. If you have any doubt on Spring Boot, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.